Right, now this is a bit of an unusual one, right? So today, Mark and Howard are going to traverse Whitbarrow Scar. Whitbarrow Scar. And it's near to Dad's farm at Bowland Bridge, and we've been dropped off by Dad, and we have no map, we have no guide, we're just going to follow our noses and head right the way along the scar, and when we see Haycock Farm we're going to come back. Now I think it's about a 5 mile walk, something like that, but this is probably how not to tackle walks in the Lake District, but it has a lot of excitement just because of that, we think. So wish us luck, here we go, Whitbarrow Scar. We have been walking for 15 steps and we've come across this. So here it says public footpath, but this way is the path that we were just dropped off and told to head up. So do we go straight on or do we turn left? No idea. So we started in a little hamlet by the Lythe Valley Hotel called The Row, and it's just one woodland path that keeps on going. We've been on it now for about a quarter of a mile, so not much to look at really. It isn't unpleasant, far from it, but that is where we are going. Onwards and upwards. It ain't going well. We've been walking for a while and we haven't even hit a view. It's been in woodland and we're not at the top of any scar. We haven't got a clue what's happening. Hi. It's been about 35, 40 minutes of walking through woodland, thinking we're low, but we've come across a sign that says, go left a bit. So that could prove to be fruitful. Come on, let's do it. When you're in the Lake District, you always talk about the views and it's always feasting the sense of sight, but it's the smells as well. You know, there's the hay, there's the vegetation, there's the very prominent smell of cow poop, cow whittle and sheep whittle. It's just lovely. Your sense of smell is always being entertained. Sniff up, Hal.
How do you feel about this then?
Oh my God, it's... I suppose when you're doing a walk that no one does along a pathway that no one treads, you got to deal with this jungle. What are we going to do?
Look, I think that might be the scar up ahead.
Oh, right.
We're not at the top of it though.
Come on, hack your way through the jungle, Prince Charming.
That morning sun peeks over the mountains and all the rhinos rub their eyes when they hear the jungle rhythm.
See, the thing is that is where we need to be, not down here.
To the jungle rhythm.
Come on.
Now you can hightail it out of the jungle, but it never leaves your heart. First you feel that beat start bubbling under, then hear the tom-tom.
It's a rather beautiful farm, yeah, that's for sure.
Sounds a lot like being free when you feel.
It must be this way.
Feel the jungle rhythm.
This is proving to be ever more puzzling. We definitely are not on the scar. We've been walking alongside it down the bottom for a while and we've come through a rather elegant farm. and we've come up a little bit hoping that we can get straight up, and there's a stile here, but it now doesn't go up, it actually veers that way, so we're no nearer to getting to the top of the scar. Come on, Hal.
This is where we start to go up.
Maybe. This is more of the same. Well, it looks like after a good hour we might be going up, but I'm not counting my chickens, frankly.
You haven't got any chickens.
That's why I'm not counting right now. The future isn't just looking good, Hal. Let's go. It's written in the moonlight. Well, this is a welcome sight. Coming through all that woodland, being very low down and making quite a rapid ascent, we come across the good old yellow arrow. And I think just over the wall may well be the top of the scar, which we should have been on about 45 minutes ago, but better late than never. That's what she said.
Any good?
Really good. Follow me to the promised land. I told you I'd lead you that way. Whitbarrow Scar, we love ya! Look at this, we have the whole fell to ourselves, perfect. What an absolute treat this is. This boulder, we're sort of on the way to a couple of cairns, which we assume is the summit of Whitbarrow Scar.
And Whitbarrow Scar is obviously a Wainwright. So we've bagged another Wainwright marking. How do you feel about that?
I feel great about that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Me too.
I'm on the top of Whitbarrow Scar! Well, we are now descending towards the Hare and Hounds at Bowland Bridge, a lovely pub. And we have thoroughly enjoyed Whitbarrow Scar after a very, very dodgy start where we clearly went wrong and didn't go up soon enough. But eventually we got there. And it was completely, the entire fell, for as far as we could see, there was no one there. Absolutely delightful. And the views over the South Lakes and the fells beyond has been terrific. But now we're on our way down. There's no path, so we're just heading towards the Hare and Hounds down there. We know what it looks like. It's near to Dad's farm. So here we go. A lovely little walk. Come on, let's get down.
Where are we going, Marky?
We're going down. Down to the Hare and Hounds. Down to the Hare and Hounds. Now look, we're trying to get down, right? Trying to get down, and we're right on the scar, and it goes forever and ever and ever. So we're stuffed a little bit, but I quite like that. It suits my personality and my chaotic flying by the skin of my pants thing I do. This is a sheer drop, really. But maybe, just maybe we can negotiate our way if we zigzag.
I think it's a really silly idea, but right, then I don't want to lose any.
All right, okay. No, we won't do it then.
I don't want it to be called boring.
No, no, no. He's a bit boring, all right? But come on, come on. Let's go up then. We're going up! Going up! That farmhouse, that small holding, is perfection for me. It's really tasteful, really well kept, and I will have something like that. I know I will. So, we got down in the end, and Whitbarrow Scar completed. And now the blessed pint, perfect. Lach home.